Hey guys, welcome to the channel. A short video to show you how to configure the Hermes DDC and the Terminator 2 DAC. I have these two connected to the Hestia preamp and a pair of Genelec loudspeaker on my desktop setup. Okay, let me show you the back. The power cord is connected to the Hermes. USB cable goes to my MacBook Pro. HDMI I2S cable goes to the Terminator 2 DAC I2S A input. AES EBO1 output connected to AES1 input of the Terminator 2. Power cord connected to the Terminator DAC. And the power is coming from this BIC500VA. Right. And the Hestia preamp is in use here. The yellow cable is from Sommer cable, it's connected to the output of the Terminator 2 DAC. You notice I have two extra cable connected from the Terminator 2 clock output to the Hermes DDC clock input. It's kind of difficult to see, I know, but when you connect the clock cable, please take note that the clock frequency 45 MHz has to be connected to the 45 MHz of the Hermes preamp. My phone is not getting the focus, let me see. Right, 45 MHz to 45 MHz and 49 MHz to 49 MHz. Once you have the cable connected and power on, the next thing to do is to configure this guy. I would advise to turn the clock signal on the Hermes DDC to off mode. As soon as the clock LED here turned on, the Hermes DDC is expecting the clock connection from the Terminator 2. Just in case the clock frequency of the Terminator 2 wasn't set up correctly, the Hermes is not going to output any digital signal. So for a start, I would recommend to turn off the clock of the Hermes DDC. This is how you do this. Press on the setup button once, and press on the optical button a couple of times. So as I toggle this optical button in setup mode, the clock LED turn on and off. I will leave it to off for now. Press the setup button again to confirm the setting. So the USB is already connected to my MacBook Pro. I'm using the Audivana software here. The DAC will be detected as a USB device over here. So it is already selected and playing music nicely from the MacBook Pro Audivana to the Hermes DDC over USB. You also notice I have two cable connected at the back of this DAC and DDC. One is the AES EBU cable, the other one is the HDMI I2S. The reason I use the AES one here is really because it helps me to check the I2S connection from the DDC to the DAC. So I2S is a bit more complex and it requires setup in order to work, but AES EBU, on the other hand, it works right away as you connect the two devices together. So it tells us that when the Hermes DDC is playing music and the Terminator 2 is connected to the AES one and it is also playing music from the source, which is the MacBook Pro, to the Hestia preamp and to the pair of Genelec loudspeaker, we know that the signal is sending from the computer to the DAC. Sorry, from the computer to the DDC and to the DAC, as well as the Hestia preamp and the pair of loudspeaker, and the signal is flowing. So AES EBU is working, and the next thing to do is really to check the I2S pinout. So I'll pause the music. So for Hermes and Terminator 2 DAC, I would recommend to set the I2S pinout of the Hermes DDC to mode 000. So how do we do this? Press on the setup button once and press on and toggle the coaxial button multiple times. So as you can see, as I toggle this coaxial button, the 48K, 96K and 192K LED turn on and off. So this signifies 000 to 111 setting. So leave the setting to off, off, off. 48K off, 96K off and 192K off. So once you have confirmed this setting, press on the setup button again. So this setting will be stored in the memory chip of the Hermes DDC. The next time you power it up, you will be using the same setting. So I2S is setting on the Hermes is set to mode 0. And the next thing to do is to set up the I2S pinout of the Terminator 2 DAC. Press on the input plus button to change the input to I2S A. And at this point in time, I would recommend to play some music that is that you are familiar. Or you can use the test tone found on the website to help you to check the channel test as well as the in-phase and out-of-phase test tone. So these are the test tone available on the website link below. Allows you to check the left-right channel of the PCM as well as the DSD and the relative priority of the left-right channel in PCM and DSD. So this test tone helps us to check the I2S pinout is configured correctly or not. So I'll play this track on the MacBook Pro. So as soon as I hit on the play button, the music will play. But I need to give you a warning. If the I2S pinout is not configured correctly, it is going to generate loud noise. So I would advise you to turn down the volume to minimal but audible and play the music. So it happens that the music play on the right channel correctly. And the next one is DSD. Now, DSD will have a lot of noise. And this noise is kind of dangerous to the loudspeaker. We need to turn down the volume again, just a precaution, to make sure the excessive noise doesn't damage the loudspeaker. And we can continue to play the DSD. And as we play DSD, change the I2S pinout on the Terminator 2. This is how you do this. Hit on the mute button once. As the mute engage, the input LED turn on and off from the left to the right. And toggle the phase button multiple times. You will see the 1X, 2X, and 4X LED turn on and off. So leave it at one of the mode that can play the music without noise. So just now we were testing the DSD, and DSD there are some noise. I'll play the DSD again and hear for ourselves whether it plays correctly. Now it plays correctly, and the PCM plays correctly as well. So now I can turn up the volume to hear whether the tone are playing correctly. Hang on a second, there's a channel swap for the DSD. So, sorry for the video. I'm using a handheld to take this video. Okay, let me play right channel DSD. Okay, the DSD is swapped. The right channel is supposed to play on this loudspeaker, but it play on the left one. There's a trick to change the priority, or rather, the left-right channel of the DSD. The trick is available on the DDC as well as on the DAC. I'll do this on the DAC. Hit on the mute button once and hit on the OS and NOS button. You'll see the coaxial LED and AES1 LED turn on and off. So this toggle the DSD channel left and right swap. I'll leave it at AES1 and I will try to play the right channel DSD again. Right. Now it is playing correctly. Right, this is the left channel. And the PCM play correctly as well. So we know that the I2S pinout is configured correctly for the DDC and DSD to play both PCM and DSD. I know it's kind of complicated, but as you get accustomed to this I2S pinout check, and you'll be all good. So beside this left-right channel test, we will also need to tell the in-phase and out-of-phase. So this is in-phase. This is out-of-phase for PCM. And the next one will be DSD. In-phase for DSD. Out-of-phase for DSD. So as you can see, when the DSD is playing, the DSC will display DSD. So it tells us that DSD is being played just now. Right, and the next one we will look into is to turn on the clock of the Hermes DDC to sync with the clock of the Terminator 2 or the Terminator Plus DSC. So I have the clock turned off on the Hermes DDC just now. I will turn it on So before I turn it on, I just want to show you how to configure the Terminator 2 clock out function. Press on the mute button once, and press on the input minus multiple times. As you can see, as I toggle the input minus button in this clock configuration mode, the clock out LED turns on and off when the I2S A LED is on. So there are a few clock selection here that allows you to change the clock out frequency of the Terminator 2 or the Terminator Plus. For Hermes DDC, Iris DDC or the Gaia DDC, please leave the LED on at OPT. So this output the 45 and 49 MHz at the back of this connector, and the back of the connectors are connected to this Hermes DDC. You know that the correct output frequency will drive this DDC to synchronize the clock. So after a couple of seconds later, the front panel LED will back to normal operation mode, where the last selected input will light up and the sampling rate LED will light up as well. Now, we have set up the Terminator 2 DAC clock output. In order for the Hermes DDC to receive the clock signal, we need to turn on the clock over here. So how do we do this? Press on the setup button once and toggle the optical button. So as I toggle this button, you can see that the clock LED turned on. We should leave the clock LED turned on and hit on the setup button once to confirm the setting. So now, if I play music and the music play fine, we know that the clock is synchronized. Let me hit on the play button. Hang on a second. I like to find the music that I like. Okay, the piano, Iruma. Okay, music is playing fine. Right. So it is playing 44.1 kHz and the DSC received 44K1 1X. What if you have the clock frequency set up incorrectly? Let me do this. Here on the mute button, press the input minus button a couple of times, turn off the clock. So when the Hermes DDC did not receive the clock from the Terminator 2, the music will stop. So we need to set up the clock output correctly. Hang on a second. Hit on the mute button once. Hit on input minus multiple times to set up the clock. Leave the clock at OPT. So it will output the correct clock to the DDC to synchronize the clock. Why there are two cables? Let me show you the back. 45 MHz is responsible for 44.1 kHz sampling rate music. 49 MHz is responsible for 48 kHz sampling rate, the base sampling rate. So if I have one of the cable disconnected, let me see. Yeah, currently it's playing 44K1. So if I have the 45 MHz cable disconnected, the music will stop. It is really because the Hermes DDC stopped receiving the clock. So the clock cable has to be connected firmly in order for the clocks to synchronize between the two devices. So let me connect this clock again. Yeah, music continues to play. So what if your music is only 44.1 kHz and you do not want to use the other cable? Yes, it is possible. But do take note that if you have this cable disconnected, everything that is on this 49 MHz, let's say for example 48K, 96K, 192 kHz, will not be played because the clock is not present. I would advise to connect both clocks just in case you need them. Alright, music is playing and the clock synchronization between the two devices is done correctly. I hope this video helped. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.